Proper winterization includes dropping the water level to a sufficient level. In this case, on a concrete pool, you want to drop it down about 12 inches. Then you would want to check chemistry and add the appropriate winterization chemicals, which would include a non-chlorine shock, a stain and scale remover, and also an algicide. This is what we're in the process of doing now. This helps protect the surface of the plaster and keeps the water clear until about, in this climate, about mid-April. At that time, you would open the pool. Besides dropping the water level and adding the appropriate chemicals, you also want to blow the lines. In this case, we have blown the skimmer lines and put in adequate skimmer protection, which we call a super gizmo. It's not just a name we give it, but it's what is actually the name of the product. Let's see, I'm going to turn it around for you. And that gizmo, in this case a super gizmo, I don't know if you can read that or not, what it does is, one, it sealed the pipe at the bottom of the skimmer so we can blow that line. And as you can see, it's a soft plastic. It's pliable. Over the winter, as this plastic housing fills with water from snow melt and rain and whatever, and it fills with water, the soft plastic will absorb any freeze expansion, thus saving the plastic housing from breakage. And that's the purpose of a gizmo, in this case a super gizmo. We're going to put the basket back in place. All right, and we put the lid back on. All right. As you can see, we're putting in, finishing out the chemicals. All right, and besides blowing the line, which is very important, because our philosophy, if there's no water in those lines, then there's nothing there to freeze. Water in the line, something to freeze, and there you have problems because your piping is underground, and some cases as much as 3 feet, some cases 6 feet, sometimes it's even more shallow. Here out in western Virginia, I would imagine the freeze line is probably at least 24 inches. In this case, I know when we built this pool, we put those lines 30 inches. So we've got the water level down. We've added the appropriate chemicals. We've blown the lines. And it's also important to make sure there's no water in the equipment itself. So coming down here, where the heat pump is, we've not only blown the water out of it, we actually loosened those two unions down there at the bottom to make sure the water's out. We removed the drain plug on the Polaris pump, which is that little pump there, and we removed the plugs on the edge pump. Now in this case, you're going to see that I've got some valves closed. We've gone through the process because this is below the level of the pool, below the level of the basin where this equipment is. We have blown air and pushed air back past these valves and then closed the valves before water could return. So in essence, we have, between that valve and the pool itself, we actually have an airlock. Again, no water, no freeze. Now there's several other things that you do in the process. Of course, we have previously cleaned the salt generation cell, taken out the plugs in the pump, and on this one, because it is an edge pump, it has a check valve. We had to actually disassemble that check valve, and in this case, there's another one up underneath. That's what that unit is right there. And if you can look at this, you can see that there's a water trap in that 90, and we've made sure there's no water there. So just thinking that you've got everything, you've got to check and make sure that there's no water standing anywhere. And that's part of the process of winterization. And that's what's going to protect your pool until spring, so you can enjoy it next season as well.